Remember those golden nunchucks offered in Club Nintendo? They're sold out now, but it looks like they might be coming back. A notice on the page for the item now says that Nintendo is hoping to make them available again. My advice? Start racking up those coins. On Monday, Masahiro Sakurai gleaned that he is having fun creating new characters for the next Super Smash Bros. During the keynote of the Computer Entertainment Developers Conference in Japan. I won't be happy until I see at least one Gundam, or the game itself, in my hands. On Tuesday, Nintendo fans received a bit of bad news when Future Publishing announced that they are shutting down the much-loved Nintendo Power magazine. A number of factors contributed to this shutdown, some being the fact that Nintendo was uninterested in renewing its contract, and also it didn't want to take the magazine digital. It was a good run while it lasted. The magazine's monthly readership of 475,000 can expect their last issue to arrive in December 2012. On the lighter side of things, Nintendo announced that they are holding a Wii U press event in NYC on September 13th, making September 13th my new date of birth. And oh yeah, the day we probably find out a release date and pricing for this thing. Soccer is a game enjoyed by both men and women, which makes some fans wonder, why don't FIFA games feature women? When EA's David Rutter was pressed on the matter due to a petition calling for EA to put women's teams in its FIFA series, David said women in the game is always something considered in some shape or form, and it's not to say it won't ever happen. Considering that the United States was represented in Olympic soccer by women alone, it might be time for EA to step it up. Wednesday officially marked Zelda's 25th anniversary in the US, so we're gonna not do anything for that. Or are we? Counting Sunday, it's been 5 whole days since the release of New Super Mario Bros. 2, and fans in North America are wondering, where are those digital download cards? It seems as if Nintendo might have dropped the ball on this one, as when asked about the matter, they simply stated, no North American retailers are currently selling or have any plans to sell New Super Mario Bros. 2 download cards. Some retailers, such as GameStop, have opted to print digital codes on receipts instead, and it should be noted that these cards are indeed available in Japan. Owners of a 3DS and fans of the Pokemon series should be happy to hear that an update for Pokédex 3D will arrive on August 31st. The update will immediately unlock 6 Pokemon and will also make all other Pokemon downloadable through SpotPass. Users of Pokédex 3D are expected to use the update button located inside the app to update, but I'm assuming that there will be an update available from the eShop. In the US, it seems like bookstores are shutting down left and right. On the eShop? Not so much. Circle Entertainment announced on Friday that Bookstore Dream, a storefront simulation game, will be making its way to the 3DS eShop on September 13th. What? I like simulation games. Renegade Kids' Jules Watcham blogged about bonus content for Mutant Muds possibly making its way to the 3DS. While the 20 new levels added to the PC version of the game might seem like a lot for 3DS owners to miss out on, Jules reminded us that it's not an impossibility, but the process to bring the extra content to the 3DS is a long one, including ESRB submission and approval from Nintendo. So if you're waiting for this add-on, don't hold your breath too long. And that's it for this week. Stay tuned next week for a look inside the bubble. We'll be right back. owners of 3DS and fans of Pokems. Owners of 3DS, owners of the 3DS and fans of... Wow.